Hello and welcome to another Home Audio Academy blog. The intention of this episode is to give you some hints about sound and its properties. I think in order for a person to become a good producer, audio engineer, or even a musician who wants to record at home, you should have at least a basic understanding of sound. Why is this important? Well, it will help you understand how sound works. The information shown here is very important because the concepts you are about to learn will come up in all aspects of audio production, engineering, and sound recording. So what is sound? Well, let's have a look at what we can find by searching the internet. Let's have a look at what a web dictionary defines as sound. Right, some results. Well, here is a definition from the free dictionary. Okay. Well, as you can see, there's many ways to define sound. Although my favorite one is here, described in the general physics section here. Okay, so it's described as a periodic disturbance in the pressure of density of a fluid or in the elastic strain of a solid. Produced by a vibrating object, it has a velocity in air at sea level at 0 degrees Celsius of 331 meters per second or 741 miles per hour and travels as a longitudinal wave. In this definition, we have some very important points. Sound is a disturbance in pressure in a fluid or a solid. Also note that gas is also fluid. Sound travels at a particular speed, but it appears that temperature of the fluid has an influence on it, since the definition states a value for the temperature, and that the substance that it travels through also determines its speed. There is one more important point, that sound travels in longitudinal waves. The concept of sound traveling as a wave might be a bit difficult to imagine, but I have found a very good website that will help you learn and visualize how sound moves as a wave. This website was created by Professor Dan Russell. Professor Russell has some fantastic explanations and images of waves, their movement, and how they affect each other. The link in the description of this video will take you to our website that has a list of links I refer to in this video. Let's have a look at an example of a wave. If you click on this link, longitudinal and transverse waves, you will see a very good example of what a sound wave might look like. Imagine that this grey line here is a vibrating speaker cone surface. If you have not seen a speaker vibrate, here is what it looks like. Here you can see the cone of the speaker move as it's producing the sound. So let's imagine that the grey line on the image is this surface. In the animation, you can see the speaker push on the air particles, squashing them together. But you can also see it pull them apart. As this happens, you can see the clump of squashed air particles travel away from the speaker. One important observation here is that the individual air particles are not actually being shot across the diagram. They just seem to move back and forth within a specific area. Keep an eye on this red dot. Looking at this image, can you see a wave pattern forming? If not, let me see if I can help you represent the wave as a line on a graph. If we go back to the previous page and click on the standing longitudinal sound waves link, you will see this page. Let's scroll down a little. Ah, here we go. You can see the grey line pushing the air particles, but below in red you can see a graph showing a line representation of the air pressure change. I'm going to draw a line across the screen here, which will help you align the graph position. Okay, and we're done. What the graph is representing is the change in air pressure. When the air particles are squashed together, the result is a high pressure point. But when they are pulled apart, it is shown as a low pressure point. When this is plotted on the graph, it starts to look like a wave. Can you see the wave pattern now? If you are still having trouble with visualizing waveforms, Have a read of the articles on this site. Try starting with this one. What is a wave? But for now, this is the end of this episode. More about waves in the next one. If you like these tutorials, please rate and subscribe. I will be making these regularly. The full schedule for what I will be covering is on our website, www.homeaudioacademy.com. The link is in the description. If you have any questions, please post them in the comments section below. See you next time.